he is, right?
All right, hello again, guys. This is Leontes with LK404.
Hey, LK404 here.
Doing another Codex card time strategy battle video of the core set, Moss Sentinels versus Blood Anarchs. I'm on the right there playing green.
And I'm playing mono red.
And this is the second game we played. First one, green won with some really aggressive use of Circle of Life, a Midori spell that sacrifices a unit to upgrade it to another thing, and I did really, really messed up things with that, and it was pretty good.
And Red's failure to destroy a Tech 3 building.
Yeah, and led to the Tyrannosaurus Rex getting played, and I was able to snipe out his Tech 2 and Tech 3 and deny him his pirate gunship from the Anarchy tech line. So one thing I want to talk about with Red in general is that in some games, it seems like the aggro style is like the more simple, mindless gameplay style, where the more control-y, stall-y sorts of decks are much more complicated to play. I think it's almost the opposite in Codex. I think that in this game, Red might be one of the highest skill cap things you can play. Being able to just do lots of interesting combat math and figure out exactly when you can all in your opponent's base, when it's just enough to let go of all your defenses and just run rampant into your opponent and just win that way. There's a certain point in the game when you can do that. It's really hard to figure that out. And we're going to see how that translates to a game right now, because I believe that that's like the moral of the story here in this one.
Yeah, a lot of Red's cards both deal damage to patrollers, units. They also deal damage to buildings. And so you can go for face, just hit their base and try to like close out the game. Or you can go for board and try to kill their units and have board control.
Kill the heroes and remove spell options and whatnot.
Yep.
All right, so flipping the golden panda coin, see who goes first. Okay, it looks like it's going to be green, maybe?
Looks like it. We're not changing the worker cards, so...
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so it looks like Red, which is kind of generally wants to be the more attacky side, is actually going second. And so Green's going to have a chance to put up a patroller first instead of getting the three free damage at the beginning of the game.
Mm-hmm. Because a decent Red starter, if you want to go an aggro strat, is to play like Zane and a Madman on turn one, and then just do three to the base and make a worker. Green has no haste, so you don't have to worry about patrolling on turn one. But I think I do a pretty standard starting build here. Very, very econ-centric. Let's see. Is it Prospector or Rich Earth? Let's see what I got. So two gold gets me Rich Earth. So this is the my workers are free for forever. And so I make a free worker, no gold cost for that, and I pay two. I don't want to play any more cards because I'm at three cards, so I pay two gold to summon Argigarg. And
that gets you a defender.
And that puts a 0/1 wisp into play. So I put that there. I'm going to put Argigarg in the squad lead because he's a 1/3 at base, and
with an armor.
That armor's great. So that there's not going to be any Madman, Zane, Frenzy.
So I have to pull out something crazy to be able to deal four damage on the first turn.
Yep.
Like four hasted damage on the first turn.
Yep. So pretty safe start for Green. I think there's no way you're gonna get in, but I'd rather get the extra gold than the technician.
Workering the Rambaster, it looks like, giving up on the early base damage.
Yeah, it's really hard to get the Rambaster through a patrol zone, so you typically want to play it on turn one, or when the board's clear. It's just a 1/2 with haste. It's not that good of a unit when you don't have a clear path to buildings. So let's see. Does he play the tech one now, or I think this game you might actually SQ tech one for a while. I think you wait.
I think so. Thinking real hard.
Let's see, it could be like Blood Rage Ogre is super real.
Is that a Blood Rage Ogre at the back of the hand? Looks like a Bombaster to me, probably. Spending three
for the Bloodburn. Yeah, Bloodburn's an upgrade, so I played an upgrade, he played an upgrade.
And spending one for Nautical Dog, going down a card on the very first turn.
Nice, so Red's getting a little bit excited here.
Yeah, what are these plays?
So Bloodburn is a upgrade, it's cost three gold, and whenever a unit dies, unit or hero, or unit?
A unit. Whenever a unit dies, it gets a rune on it. You can spend two runes to deal one damage to a unit.
Excellent. And that's any unit or building, right?
Yeah, any unit or building.
So this is part of Red's like end plan to just do unresistible damage to your base or to just clean up the patrol zone by getting that extra one damage here and there. And I think you have to exhaust it to do that. So you can't like
once,
just...
Yeah, so once per turn.
Yeah, once per turn. But it's good to... You can almost get kills on things, and then Bloodburn will finish it off. And that's going to help him get through the patrol zone and get to meteor targets.
It also does things like kill that Wisp that comes with Argarg. So instead of you getting... instead of you getting free blockers that I have to waste attackers to go through, I can tap Bloodburn, deal one to a Wisp, and move him out of the way.
Yep. And notably, Ryan doesn't know this, but I was going to... Yeah, I'd take one damage from the Nautical Dog. I was going to play... I was going to take a Giant Panda. I was going to go a very Wisp-heavy strategy this time because I was going first. And I was like, well, I'll just turtle up my board and go this massive Econ thing. I see a Bloodburn on turn one. That changes my tech pattern completely. And I'm no longer going to deal with Giant Panda because I know that the Wisps just won't stick. And I'm going to just... I removed the Giant Panda and I put in two Centaurs, I believed. I went back to being a really heavy thing. So there I panic and I put a Wisp in the resist spot.
To try to make me pay a gold to kill the Wisp.
Yep. Because the Bloodburn's targeted ability means it's going to cost him one. So it's not going to be so easy, all right? He doesn't have enough runes on it anyway. He'd have to kill my one of his own units or kill my Ironbark Treant, which as we know is a big 1-5 right now in that squad lead spot. Arg has one damage on him, not a really big deal. He's a hero that levels up to 5, so it doesn't take very many levels for him to heal up. I believe it's just 2, and then he maxes out, so it's fine. Blood Rage Ogre on the table.
Blood Rage Ogre?
That's usually like... Blood Rage Ogre and Ironbark Treant are like sworn enemies. Like, they are the cards that you'd use that one to deal with the other. Is kind of how they play. This is the two largest units in
and
Red
go
and Green
immediately
started.
For Heroes Hall over Tech 1.
Okay, so yeah, Tech 1 would have been how you play the Tech 1 units, but what that tells me is that he's teching spells. He wants to be able to play two different heroes and play lots of spells because he can't even play Tech 1 units yet. And why would he spend the one gold for it if he doesn't even have it in his deck, right? I guess you could do that. You could kind of bluff, but he needs as much gold as he can.
Wow, floating one gold even. I could build the Tech 1 and just declining not to. Just declining to build
it. Yeah. Right on. So 6 gold for
I'll
green.
I'll learn how to speak English someday.
Yeah. So let's see. I have my way to get through the Ogre now with the Ironbark Treant, and that's good. This is the only unit on the board. I have an Argarg. I think Arg is going to do the rare, like, I swing Argarg at your base. I think that might happen this turn.
Deal one damage to my base.
Sure. I mean, I don't know. I guess I could block. It's always tough decisions. Red has a lot of haste. Let's see. Conundrums. I have to be wary about playing the one health dudes in my deck now because green has a guy called Merfolk Prospector. It's one gold and... he has an exhaust ability where you just exhaust him and you get a gold. But I can't really play him.
Because he's not going to live.
So I know that Wisp is going to die. So I cast Rampant Growth on it, making it a 2-3. And I level up Argarg to middle, giving him access to that middle ability of tap him and give one attack and armor to a thing. So I make my Wisp trade with the Blood Rage Ogre. That way he doesn't get a free kill on it with the Bloodburn. Bloodburn's going to gain 2 counters right now, though, because this is when any unit dies.
Yep, so his unit died, my unit also died. Force Favor.
Yeah, Force Favor
and
that.
Destroy the Heroes Hall.
I destroy the Heroes Hall, because I'm like, I'm not having any of that. So I put 4 attack on my Ironbark. Instead of blocking, like, maybe blocking was better. I think we learned that maybe I shouldn't have done that. We'll see what happens right now. But my Patrol Zone's empty. Argarg is a 1-4, and the Ironbark Treant is a 4-3, so I don't have a lot of health in the backfield. I see a handful of spells on the red side.
Yep, and no heroes yet. Heroes were not left vulnerable until I needed to cast stuff.
Yep, that way they're not face down in the command zone when the time is right. So, surprise attack. Here comes 2 sharks. So yeah, stretch goals on Kickstarter, guys. We want to get some cool shark tokens for that.
Give me some shark tokens.
You'll see why the necessity at the end of this game of why we need those.
Yeah, so 3-1 units with haste. 3 damage to the Treant. It's enough to kill it. And then 3 damage, and attacking with Zane is enough to kill Argarg.
Yep, and Arg only does 1 damage. He's more of like a castery kind of buffy hero, so he doesn't have a lot of attack on his own, so Zane's going to survive that, but then he'll level up after the combat and heal off the 1 damage.
Yep, so Zane is now at level 3 mid-band with no damage.
So maybe I should have patrolled that.
And Bloodburn gets another counter from killing the Ironbark.
Yeah, so maybe I should have just patrolled that Ironbark. Maybe the going for the Heroes Hall was not the right play. But sometimes you gotta take risks in this game.
Spending the 1 gold to build the Tech 1 building.
Finally.
Yeah.
I did make you waste the 2 gold in the Heroes Hall, so I feel kind of good about that.
To be fair, you also spent 2 gold to do it.
True. I played a Force Favor.
Force Favor.
Yep. 6 gold gets me, I think, Double Centaur, yeah. Like
Double Centaur.
Screw this. Tired of these sharks. And they have 4 health, so
make a worker. 4 health, which is 1 shy of getting killed by sharks.
Make a worker for free because of Rich Earth, and I float 1 gold. Let's see if I hang on to that gold, considering red things. Yeah. I'm looking at the gold. I'm looking at the cards in my hand.
Oh, Zane's at mid-band. Are you sure you want to give me a gold? Give me a card.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure that out right now. Like, do I need the gold or do I need the card?
Yeah, because if we see a hasty taxman come out again, that's enough to steal that gold.
Mm-hmm. And Bloodburn's going to do at least 1 damage to a centaur, so he's going to be able to get through those centaurs if he has surprise attack again. Notably, I'm trying to get guys on the table because I'm like, you know what? I'm not giving you anything. I'm not going to give you any cards. I'm not going to give you any gold. I'm good where I'm at.
Man, setting up your patrol zone, it's a big decision.
Yeah. Especially against guys that, like, steal the buffs from you. And if you guys saw my hand, I have 2 copies of a card called Spirit of the Panda, and it's Argagarg's buff. He's dead right now, but I could summon him next turn and play him. But what it does is, like, it attaches to a unit and gives it +2/+2. I'm desperately trying to get one of these centaurs to survive this turn. I just hope that he doesn't have anything in his hand that will prevent me from doing that.
But again, the recurring theme of if you tech spells and then your hero gets killed, you can't do it.
Yep. Well, more so, I just need a unit with which to buff that can then attack.
Yeah, because Argagarg is going to come back next turn.
Yep. But let's see what red does here. Red, such an explosive color.
Yeah. The red player taking kind of long turns. There's a lot of math.
Yeah, it's it's not just I put all my guys on the table and I just like tap them all. It's tough.
No, you only have so much gold. Sharks.
Surprise attack again. So this is shark counter to 2.
Surprise attack.
And so those do 3.
We got to get that card renamed to Shark Attack.
Shark Attack. Shark Week.
Yeah.
So let's see. Zane has 3 attack, but he'll die to a centaur. So we got a Bloodburn to do 1 damage to the elite slot centaur, giving it 3 health remaining. So 1 shark will kill that. How do you get through the first centaur, though?
Yeah, you gotta peg just 1 extra damage on the first centaur. Or no, 2 extra.
2 without losing Zane. Maybe you do lose Zane. Maybe that's what you do here.
Maybe I pay 3 for Scorch. Do I have Scorch in my hand?
Yep. Oh, wait, no.
Bombaster.
Bombaster. And then you sacrifice the Bombaster immediately to do 2?
Yeah, that's a Scorch.
Yep. So it puts...
pay 3 to deal 2.
Yeah, and then it puts the Centaur to 3 health exactly, which will be enough for a shark to crash into it.
Yep. And then Bloodburn gets a...
makes the other one 3 health.
Yep.
And then the 2 sharks smash into those... and they both die. Zane's still alive. Zane can then attack still.
Bloodburn should be exhausted, but like I counted down the runes. We know what's up.
Yeah. So then mix a worker. And then Zane's going to hit something. I guess you hit...
Tech 1 for 3 damage.
Okay.
Showing me the... that's reciprocating the pirate gunship from last game where...
Yep. Like, here's like, my Spirit of the Pandas. I needed a unit with which to play it.
Yeah, here's these 2 things in my hand that I can't play.
So Arg is back, which means I can play Spirit of the Panda, but I'm not holding any units. So it's an attached to a unit ability. So I'm like, man, now I have a completely dead hand, and that's the thing you do not want against red. Like, if you have no way to defend against a red board with Zane who's spamming sharks at you, It could just be over now. So I summon Arg. I get that Wisp for free when he comes into play. And I put Spirit of the Panda on the Wisp as, like, desperation, just trying to keep Zane out. It's my only play. Making that Wisp a 2-3.
I love it, though. You got to make it work.
Yep, suboptimal plays for days, but there's one. So Spirit of the Panda goes in.
+2/+2 on the Wisp.
Yep, something I've never done before. If it ever gets to attack, it's going to gain me a gold as well. But I'll just make it a 2-4, I guess, in that slot. 3-3? What am I doing? 3-3.
I don't know about that 3-3.
I don't want to give you cards or gold. If I put them in scav or tech, then you get extra stuff when you kill it. And all right. The squad lead.
But yeah, for in.
Oh, and then I
put a 1/1 rune
yeah,
on.
Yeah, and I played a
buffest,
Force Favor.
Buffest
so I have
Wisp ever.
The buffest Wisp that you've ever seen. It's a 3/5.
Yeah, you should mid-ban Midori and get like another +2/+2.
I can't. Spirit of the Panda gives him an ability.
Yeah,
and
it does.
Makes it so it doesn't work. So I put Arg there, expecting him to die. I drew my two spells, so there's no reason for me to keep him in play any longer. If he can survive to a turn, I might max him out so that I can get that water elemental for his max ban.
What?
Shark attack again. So he's just getting like perfect cycles. His deck is thinned out. He's doing good.
Spends a counter or spends two runes to deal one damage. To...
Yeah, knocks the rune off of the Wisp. Or the armor, rather.
Yeah, so... Wisp still is a 3-4 right now.
Yeah. But you have two sharks, so...
Oh, taking it back.
I think you might just need to shark. Yeah, I'm just using both sharks. Okay. Just like, it's fine.
I spent four. Yeah, I think that's what happens. Shark. To kill a Wisp.
Yep, two sharks, eat a Wisp.
So to be fair, you paid 4 for that Spirit of the Panda,
and
you paid another
2
for the first favor.
It was an 8 gold play to get one blocker. Yeah.
And then I got rid of it for 4.
Yep, so pretty bad tempo right now.
That's pretty value.
I think you can just kill Arg with
Max Ban Zane, kill Arg, and I get the card draw.
Yep.
And this is a big part of what's helping me out is you're giving me card draw.
Yep. And that's how he's getting through his deck faster to get to sharks quicker.
Yeah, because check this out. I'm gonna get another reshuffle right now.
Mm-hmm. See the pillage on the top there. So if I don't play,
oh man, am I gonna play?
You should.
I should. Steal that gold.
Yeah, here you go. Oh no, you don't. You build your Heroes Hall again.
All right. Discard Heroes Hall, discard, and I get another reshuffle, so I get another chance to...
I see. You drew 5 cards there. If you played the Pillage, you would have drawn only 4.
Yeah.
But you're doing good. So again...
So after the reshuffle, I get another chance to draw into more sharks and units.
Yep. And so green has no board yet again. But I still have a tech 1 building. My base is a little bit hurt. I think it's somewhere around like 17 right now. I should be using those red d6s so we can see.
Free worker
is good. 4 gold is gonna get me a tech 2. I'm like, you know what,
yep,
this is my way out.
That sounds like the correct thing to do. Go to tech 2.
And I'm getting balance because I need that wandering mimic to deal with Zane. I gotta get that haste guy to have a fast acting play a tiger cub. So just I pay it real 2 gold. It's a 2/2 and it has no ability, so if I can somehow get Midori out, the Tiger Kill will get stronger. Has to be a mid-ban Midori. But notably, not enough health to survive a shark attack. So Midori comes out, and I'm like, you know what? I'll just technician him as well. I need cards. I need to get through this. Last 2 gold is... Yeah, I'm just going to float it and hope you don't... Do nasty things.
Keeping the last 2 gold and only discard 1, draw 3.
Yep. But notably now, I'm at 10 workers, so I don't have to tech anymore. And hopefully I can get through my deck and find the tech 2s that I need to survive this onslaught.
Gain 9 from my side.
I see a handful of spells.
Notably, no use out of that Heroes Hall so far. Just Zane.
Yep. You could play
I paid Jaina for that Heroes Hall twice and haven't used it yet.
Yeah.
Paying 4. 4 sharks.
Shark attack. So this would be the fourth time he's played I think it's four straight turns.
Yeah, I think so. I think it's just been perfect draws.
Yep. That's just good cycling. It's just having control over...
One shark kills the...
Yeah, and it's also me using a technician. If I weren't using the technician slot at all...
So yeah, that... Oh, there we go.
You bring out Jaina so you can give Jaina some levels.
Yeah, so Jaina gets two levels from killing Midori. And I get the card draw from Zane's midband.
Mm-hmm.
Get a counter on Bloodburn as well.
And so if you have more than three cards, you're going to probably cast something. Zane can attack still.
There's still an Ember Sparks on the in my hand, so it looks like I can pay three to trash the Tech 1 building.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know if that's the right call. I think actually the right call is for Zane to destroy the Tech 2 building.
It's either that or it's just go base. This is why I'm saying it's difficult. It's
Bloodburn deals one to the Tech 1 building. Or Tech 2 building.
And Zane does the other four. And then that causes two damage to the base. So that was five damage to base.
Dude.
Or to Tech. Yeah.
Three for Ember Sparks. Deal two to the Tech 1. And deal another two. Actually, three to the base.
Yep.
Because the base takes one from the leftover from Ember Sparks. Takes two from the destruction of the Tech 1 building.
Yeah, I wish I could see what my health is at now. I know it's like 13 or so. It's I'm not quite in the danger zone yet, but this is what red does, though.
Yeah.
So the question is, would it have been more valuable to, instead of killing the tech buildings, I have a hand size of three, would it have been better to kill the tech buildings or just funnel all that damage into my base? So I play an Ironbark Treant, which is a tech zero unit. I bring out Argagarg and I put a Wisp into the scavenger slot.
Technician slot.
Or still technician, yeah. I pay a bunch of gold and I get a Wisp. So I max out Arg to just immediately flood my board with guys because I'm just desperately trying to block through this. I'm going to rebuild my Tech 1. I'm going to pay 2 to make a
Heroes Hall. Because
I know that if I can't get to Tech 2, then I'm going to need Heroes to survive. And so look, take a look, though. I played no Tech 1s and no Tech 2s in this particular turn. So it may have been better to, instead of just killing my Tech 1 and 2 building, to just go all out in my base. All right, so
is that my turn? It is really hard to know, though.
It's really tough.
I got punished last time for not destroying your Tech building.
Right.
And on top of that, destroying a Tech building still deals 2 to your base.
Yes.
So dealing that 2 to the Tech 1 versus dealing that 2 to the base, and I don't know.
That's actually fine.
Yeah, that seems okay.
The threat of balances Tech 2s with Zane on the board is a real threat, because if I play a Wandering Mimic, it becomes a 4-4 with haste, and I can just run it right into Zane. Zane's max band, he's a 4-4 with haste as well. So me going balance Tech 2, that's going to at least make you afraid.
Playing 3 for Ember Sparks.
Another spell. So that's a Jaina spell. It's going to...
3 damage divided as I choose among patrollers.
I think you kill the water elemental with that.
That makes sense.
Yeah, it's a 3-3. You can't tell because it's not a real token, but someday we'll have tokens. I believe it to be true. Bloodburn gains a token, or a rune.
Yeah, Bloodburn gets a rune, spends 2 runes.
Destroys the Wisp.
I get a card.
We both get cards.
Yep.
I'm going to cycle my deck now.
Let's see, can we see the top deck? It looks like a Careless Musketeer.
Or a Calypso Vistari. Or is that already in the hand?
I don't know. I definitely see a Crash Bomber in the hand. Yeah, the top deck was Careless Musketeer.
I almost don't want to play it again just to, play it. Because then it's like, oh, we're commentating this game. We're just, every
Let's see. More red math. Got to get through another 1-5 and a maxed out... There's 2 1-5s, actually. I have 10 health in the patrol zone.
However, attacking into something that only has one attack isn't that scary.
Another Sharks. So that's going to be enough to kill the Ironbark.
One card left in the deck.
Yeah, he's just cycling through.
Yeah, so when I draw my new hand, I'm still going to get a reshuffle, and I might...
And he has a reasonable shot at getting Sharks again.
Yep. How many consecutive...
It's like 5.
When I post this video, I need a counter in the corner. It's like, how many turns in a row have I played Sharks?
Yep. And it's mostly just due to the fact that I'm so desperate for cards that I'm putting a technician in, and Zane is able to steal the bonus as well. Because Red's not blocking. Red's not getting benefit out of their own tech slot. They need to steal it from the opponent. So Zane plus Shark kills
the Ironbark Treant.
Yep, Shark Jaina. You also
Jaina kills Argarg.
Argarg with the other shark.
Yes, that's enough. She goes to level 5. And okay, and then she levels up from that. Midori is alive. Kalamandra has not been played yet. It seems like with all this burn spells happening, maybe I should have gone Kalamandra.
Then,
but we'll see what happens. Kalamandra has like resist in her midband for all of her units.
And then Calypso Vistari and Crash Bomber both in hand and going for the Calypso.
Eclipse is what, 1 gold for 2/2?
1 gold for 2/2, and if you play a spell, you can exhaust her to sideline a patroller.
Any patroller, so heroes, units, any tech threes, whatever is in there, you can just move it out of the way and use your haste and burn abilities to get to the base.
So Crash Bomber is a little bit better if you think he's going to die, but looking at what you have out, I don't think Calypso is going to die this turn, so I'm not going to get the extra damage. I think getting a sideline and possibly getting a more efficient damage spread is probably better.
Indeed. Yeah, because what if I just play one big blocker? You sideline it, and then you just go to town. So I play two. I play two centaurs.
Two centaurs.
It's 8 health right there.
And three of those cards in my hand are from the new deck reshuffle.
Can we see sharks?
I think we can.
There's only 2 copies in there, guys. It's not 4.
There's no trick shuffles here.
Yeah. So I bring out both heroes. That's why I played the Heroes Hall, so yeah. I could just get heroes on the board.
Yeah, unlike me, you were immediately getting use out of your Heroes Hall.
Yeah. I'm not at Tech 2 yet. It looks like I have my Tech 2, but it's actually rebuilding. Because it died 2 turns prior, and I needed to build my Tech 1, then my Tech 2. So I may have my Tech 2s in my hand. I may not be able to play them. I know that I teched Potent Basilisk, which is a unit that when it comes in, it destroys an upgrade. That Bloodburn is getting annoying, so I want to get rid of it. It's gotten tremendous value over the course of the game.
Look at all those tokens on those heroes.
Yep.
We got 3 level tokens and a damage token.
Yep.
Yeah,
I'm just trying not to give you cards now. I'm like, that's why you're getting those sharks all the time. It's because I'm technicianing my guys.
Yeah, you finally figured it out. You're helping me cycle.
Yes. So let's see. Notably, Red has still not even built a Tech 2 yet. And I think it makes a lot of sense with the way the game is going to stay at Tech 1 and continue with the spell barrage and just try and go for the base.
Yeah, that's entirely reasonable here.
Yeah, like Red doesn't have to go to Tech 2. Like any kind of just strong aggro thing, it's like just doing a really fast early game rush in StarCraft or something. It's totally reasonable, especially if your deck is full of Ember Sparks and Sharks. Just a lot of damage on the board. You have 10 gold, though. It's really tempting.
And particularly against Green. Green doesn't have any sort of silver bullet to deal with heroes.
True. I think maybe a good reason to go to Tech 2 is to be able to summon your third hero. That's possible.
That is.
Drek has some
Give the stuff. Sharks Frenzy.
Give the sharks frenzy. So frenzy is like all your units have +1 attack. Sharks are units, so they get like they're like 4/1s. Drak has a spell called kidnapping that will
steal an opponent's unit.
Yeah, and then
for a turn
and make it hasted and attack, and so like you can remove that centaur and then crash it into the other centaur and open up the patrol zones really strong.
My guess is what happens is Calypso sidelines the centaur though.
Right.
We got Crash Bomber. Ooh, Crash Bomber with
charging
charge.
So this is a neat little trick that you can do. You
sideline
that
sidelines.
One.
Crash Bomber attacks and deals 3, and then the
dies and deals
the last one.
I think I did this wrong. But
it kills Midori, dies and deals 1 to the centaur.
That's right. Yeah, and then you still have 3 damage to go. Jaina's gonna level up from that.
Oh, dealing it to the Tech 2 instead.
Right. And then I trashed Centaur for no reason, and then you asked me why I did that. I think is what happens there. Yep. It's like, oh, yeah, whoops. I just assumed you were blowing up my entire board again.
Just getting real used to it.
Yeah.
It's like, I guess I'll get rid of my stuff. Sharks.
But there they are, so I knew it was going to happen anyway. So let's see, the Bloodburn is going to tap, do the 1 damage, and then a shark. That's four.
That's four. And then is that...
You can kill a Calamandra, or you can go...
I think that kills Calamandra. And then Zane kills the Tech 2. Zane kills the Tech 2, shark kills Calamandra.
Sounds reasonable.
And then patrol zone is entirely empty, though. And you actually have a unit?
Yeah, and have an overpower unit.
Yeah.
So Jaina is going to attack Calamandra.
Okay. And Jaina gains the levels and heals the damage.
Yes.
Oh, no, actually, she doesn't. She had a damage on her before.
Oh, yeah. So yeah, she just trades with...
Yeah, Jaina has to die. Can't possibly get through everybody. Make that happen.
And notably, my Calamandra wouldn't level or anything. It's only if the hero dies on your... If you kill a hero on your turn, you get experience. So, yeah, again, going for the Tech 2 building. Leaving a centaur alive. So I know my base is getting close. I know I'm around, like, 11 or something.
Last card in hand.
Wither Calypso.
And Zane... Where is that shark going? Shark is dealing 3 to the centaur.
Yeah. And centaur made it. So
I'm drawing a hand of 2.
Oh, I think this is a sad play where I rampant growth the centaur and it lives. And kills the Callista, the Calypso.
I would think you would kill Zane, considering... How many sharks you've had to fight against?
Yeah. I know that Arg is back now. So Arg will live now. And so yeah. And I get all my gold. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
12 total. We build your base is at 13. Yep, go. So disorganized, big pile of gold.
So yeah. Bring out Arg, I gotta cast spells.
Yeah, get your wisp.
My desperate blocker.
Come on, guys. Back this game. We need tokens.
Yep. It's a 0-1. Make a Huntress. Make a Tiger Cub.
Just flooding. Play everything.
But I play the Rampant Growth on him. And so he becomes a 3-4, a 5-4 with 2 points of armor. Calypso Vistari only has 2 attack. So
he's not going to take any damage from attacking Calypso.
Right, the armor will eat the attack, but then his overpower damage is going to flit over to Zane and kill Zane.
Which gives 2 levels to Arg.
Yeah, and so now Arg is going to go to middle. But then I pay 2 more gold, and then now he gets to maximum, and that summons me that water elemental again. So that was a huge, huge swing for me, getting that rampant growth, keeping the centaur alive, using overpower to deal with Zane, because the sharks are just getting way too real. And now I've been able to survive this and turn it around. And I know my base is getting low. So, like, looking at this match again in retrospect, I really wonder if this game could have been over already if Red had just went all in on my base instead of killing the extra heroes and whatnot. I'm not certain. And that's what makes this so tough. Like, I'm not a good Red player by any means, and I won't claim to be. But I
apparently neither am I.
But
that hand is so sad. That hand is 2 gliders and a crash barrow.
Yeah,
that hand is all Tech 2 units.
Yeah, so basically LK404 never got around to building his Tech 2, and like that this hand right here, I think, is where this all goes downhill.
Yeah, pay 4 for the Tech 2 building, but it's already too late.
Yeah, but why? Because he's gonna throw them all away at the end of this turn. And he goes into blood, which is the spec that he did with the Tech 2s. So maybe...
So there's literally nothing I can play that's in my hand.
Yeah, so maybe this would have been a good turn if those cards were not those cards. And they could be spells for Jaina or Drac or something. They could be enough damage to just hit the base and kill me. So Drac finally comes in. I'm not sure if you teched any Drac spells.
I don't think I did, but Drac deals 1 to the base when he dies.
Right, so he just a little bit more inevitability. Wow, it's just, I need cards now, and I got to draw to those Tech 2s that I just threw away. And you leave green aboard like this, and this is the beginning of the end. So now that green was able to maintain, I don't have Stampede in my deck yet. Stampede is Arg's ultimate that gives all my guys like +3 attack, and that would be like just overrun his base right now. But I don't have that. I didn't think that Arg would survive, so I didn't even tech it. But now is the time for me to come in. I play a Wandering Mimic.
No haste on the board.
Yeah, there's no Zane. So
it's no overpower on the board either.
Not yet, yeah. I just have the Sparkshot anti-air from the dude. And so Midori, though, I think I am able to pay all the gold. Yeah, I had so much gold that I was able to max Midori out immediately. And now he's full blast. That Wisp is now a 2-3. The Tiger Cub is a 4-4. And this is the turning point. Red has no board, had a dead draw due to some inefficient techs. I'm making another worker because why not? They're free. And I'm just thinning my deck out now and getting lots and lots of gold. And I don't really care if my draws are bad because, yeah, I'm in a really good spot. So, right. I going to kill Drac. So remember this when you guys play the game too. You do get experience for hero kills, so you want to like level a hero up just as much as you need to. So Midori would gain 2 levels there, so I get 2 extra gold like retroactively. So instead of maxing him out, I do that. And then I play Circle of Life.
Force Favor.
Force Favor to get the buff.
Yep.
It looks pretty similar from this distance.
Yep.
So
he gets the +1/+1 counter, which is enough for him to take out a tech building.
Yes. And then now my guys can swing. 3 damage from the Huntress, 3 damage from the Elemental. I will do enough to kill the tech too. And I'll patrol the Mimic. And Arg has done his job. He stalled me out as long as I need him to. And he made his Wisp and he made his Water Elemental. So now I'm super happy. I'm happy drawing 2 cards. I don't care. My board is great. Red is cleaned out.
There are Sharks and Ember Sparks back in that hand again.
Yep.
And looks like floating 7 gold.
Yep, Sharks and Ember Sparks. And notably, Zane and Jaina are alive this turn.
Yep.
Once you flip them over, they're going to be able to come back into play. So still, who knows? Like,
looks like a Crash Barrow as well.
Oh, no, really?
My Tech 2 is gone.
Yeah, I just killed the Tech 2.
Yep.
The Crash Barrow is a 6-2 overpower haste.
Yep.
Just a massive unit. Its job is just to run right into the squad lead, destroy it, and let everything else get by. But it looks like he's not going to be able to
cast it. It looks like destroying the Tech 2 was the right thing.
Yeah. And
rebuild the Tech 2.
And I think we're going to see a lot of Sharks. Yeah, I see the Crash Barrow there.
I set it down so I don't even look at it.
Yeah, just your shame.
It's too painful.
Yeah.
It's like, why isn't that a Flame Arrow?
Right. If that was a Flame Arrow, Flame Arrow is just it's a Jaina spell. It's just deal 4 to a unit, hero, or building.
I think it only deals 3 to a building, but yeah.
Oh, 3 to a building? Okay. But 4 to a hero is really, really, like, important.
Yep.
Because, again, the Tiger Cub has damage on it. The Wisp has damage on it. You kill Midori, you're going to just destroy 3 things at once. So, again, complicated red math. Red the mathiest of all maths.
Crash Bomber.
Bring out Zane.
Zane.
Level 1 Zane. 2 gold.
Pillage.
Deal 2 to your
base. Pillage.
Oh, steal a gold.
Steal a gold.
And 1 deal, to base.
Yeah, deal 1 to base. Crash Bomber is going to deal 1 to base as well when he dies. So, Jaina. So yeah, just playing things that will like slowly whittle your base down.
Yep. If he can't get through my patrollers and he can't possibly clear out all my dudes, he has to find a way to end the game.
So we have Ember Sparks, which might actually just all 3 go to base.
I think so.
Pay 4.
I see Sharks.
Sharks.
Yeah.
How many Sharks?
That's number 6 or 7.
Bombaster.
Pay 1. Bombaster.
Okay.
Is he going to become another Scorch? Yeah, he is.
He sacrifices, dealing 2, and then a Shark finishes off the Mimic.
Yeah.
Then... I think you do the Sparks to the base. I think this is your only opportunity here. Zane attacks.
Zane attacks into Argagarg along with the other Shark.
Yep. Doing 5, yeah. And then
I pay 2 first to level Zane so I get the card draw.
Yes, makes sense.
But I get a card. And that's important that I get a card.
Yep, you gotta get cards to keep up here. 3 gold left. I guess you could play Ember. And just go straight for the mouth. Or you need to draw cards. It's always tough decisions. You can. Yeah. That's what we say. Like, you can mostly play anything that's in your hand. It's just do you. Because you're just going to affect your draws later.
So I teched tech 2 units. I spent 4 gold on a tech 2 building in blood. And so far what's happened is I've played no tech 2 blood units. And I've had an entire turn of dead draw.
Yes. And if that was, like you said, not a crash barrow and a flame arrow instead, he would have had 4 gold from not even buying a tech 2 building. And he could play those and just start destroying my base and buildings. So
I like the little check of how many cards are left in the deck.
Yep. Bloodburn does 1 to base. Ember Sparks 3 more.
3
so
more to base. All right. Base time.
So I think I might be almost at like 7 or something. So I'm real close.
It looks like I'm changing where the levels go. It looks like for killing Midori or not killing Argagarg. Jaina's going to get the levels instead.
Right. Because Jaina has a tap ability later on that's like...
That can deal 3 to base.
Deal 3 to base, yeah.
So I can... Next turn, I can max out Jaina, tap, deal 3 to base. So if I draw like 1 more burn spell, that's enough to kill if I don't die this turn.
Yep. This is where I think I changed my health total to show you guys. I'm at 7. So again, like I wonder... Like enough stuff got through to other targets during the course of the game. Like Sharks was played so many times. I just wonder if 7 damage couldn't have gotten in instead of killing tech buildings or something. Who knows? But that's going to be one of your goals if you want to be a red player, is to learn that timing of when is it okay for me to just go all in and destroy base. So I play a mimic. This is the end game.
Wandering mimic, which has flying because of Midori.
That's flying and haste because of Midori and because of Zane. So the fact that Zane has haste is the way that I got out of this. So the Wisp is going to run into the Crash Bomber. My base takes 1. I'm down to 6. And then I basically just all in his board. And I think I might cast like another like a Forest Favor or a Rampant Growth. I'm counting up the damage now. 5, 9.
So it's really the haste. The flying doesn't 12. Matter because the patrol zone is empty.
Yeah, 12. Yeah, just the Midori buff on the Tiger Cub, the 3 from the elemental. So he drew the Ember Sparks.
So Max Jaina and Ember Sparks wins next turn if I don't get destroyed.
That would have been 6. So, yeah, it's either. It came down to like the final thing. There were so many times during that game when he destroyed either my Tech 2 building when I had Tech 2s in hand, or he killed a hero when I was holding the answer. I wanted to play a card called Mirkwood Allies for Kalamandra, which was a spell that puts like 4/1/1 frogs in my patrol or in my side of the table. But I'd patrol them all, and the job of the 1/1 frogs is to eat those sharks, the shark attacks, so they don't hit more priority targets. I had some moments pieces to try and protect from getting attacked. I just had spells of all colors,
but every time hero gets killed.
Yep. It's a counter spell. Just kill the hero, and you don't have to deal with the spell anymore.
Yeah, I think I lose there to techs. I think teching blood tech 2s may be the wrong call.
Yeah. Yeah, he went to tech. If he didn't go to tech 2 at all, he might have had a better chance at winning. And, you know, that was probably the difference. Is once I got the board back, once I was able to flood with centaurs and Argarch stuff, and he couldn't clean it out that one last time, he had to go back to a attrition mode and just try and hit base purely. And a little bit more burn, he would have made it. He was 1 turn away. So super close game.
Yeah.
Back and forth. Lots of...
There's the flame arrows at the bottom of the deck.
Yeah.
That's so terrible.
That you teched like a little bit earlier.
Yeah, teched way too late.
But you can't be sad. You played Sharks like 7 times.
Yeah, no joke. That was,
so
yeah.
When in a card game do you play the same thing like 7 times? Usually it's 4, right? but that's the nature of the deck building cycle is your...
It's what happens when you have a like 15 card deck and you have 2 copies of the thing in the deck.
And you draw like 5 a turn. It's great.
6 a turn if you're giving me the technician draw.
So what does red have? You have pillage, you had bloodburn, you have ember sparks, flame arrow, surprise attack. And yeah, that's just so much burn. It's just if you apply that pressure, there's the crash barrow. The gliders are flyers, so their job is just just to come out and fly over the patrol zone and just suicide into the base. They actually have ephemeral, so they die no matter what.
So it's like 1 for 3 damage burn spell.
Yeah, it's really interesting. So yeah, that's red versus green. That one was very back and forth. Lots of I blow up your board, you blow up mine. Yeah. And it came down to the final
turn. Down to the wire.
And actually, mathematically, if he didn't have Zane on the board, that Mimic wouldn't have had haste. And I would have done. I would have left him at exactly 3 health.
Yep.
So then, he would have survived.
And then I would have. If you didn't have enough to destroy base, I think you kill Jaina there though.
Possibly, yeah.
Yeah. So.
But yeah, maybe you would have had. Yeah, maybe I would have just blown up other options. So. But yeah, even still, super close. So reassembling our codexes. So thanks for watching, guys. I know we're really close to the black and blue stretch goal for Kickstarter, so hopefully we can show you some of that at some point in the future. But watch our other videos, see some matches between Bashing and Finesse, a couple of these matches of the core set of Moss Sentinels versus Blood Anarchs, and just keep telling friends. You know, go to Reddit, go to your card game forums, and tell people about this game, because we're really excited about it. We think it's fantastic.
Super fun, dudes.
Yeah, we want to see it grow, and we want to get those tokens. So, selfishly, we want Shark and Wisp tokens. So we need you to help us with that.
And like my favorite color is white. So you guys better unlock the.
Yeah, and white's like the last one. So we got a little bit ways to go, but we have faith that we can make it there. Thanks again for watching, and yep, just keep having fun playing good card games, guys.
Thanks. See ya.